Welcome back to Colecandoo. Today's episode is about the Separations Preview Palette, a feature I often use in any creative cloud application in a prepress role, but might be unfamiliar to some users. To show why this panel is important in prepress, let's take this example of a DL flyer that has been supplied by a client. It is being printed in full color only and has strict instructions to match the color breakdowns written on the pasteboard. While the file looks fine at a glance, it contains many errors that can be seen with the Separations Preview. This preview can be found from the Window menu, Output, and Separations Preview. Another way is by using Quick Apply and typing Separations Preview. It should be third in the list. By default, the preview is off, but can be turned on by selecting the drop-down and choosing Separations, or using the Overprint Preview shortcut. Once turned on, the preview becomes high resolution. Unlike the high resolution preview in your view options, we can see the live color breakdowns when hovering the cursor over particular areas. Starting at the top left, we can see the colors in the logo are correct, but in the line underneath, the red isn't right, and neither are the bullets. Moving on, the map point and the logo on the map isn't right either. They're showing up as spot colours. To print the artwork correctly, the colours have to be uniform throughout, so the artwork has to be fixed. To show any hidden swatches, go to the flyer in the swatches palette and select Add Unnamed Colors, and suddenly two new swatches appear. If we select the bullets or the first line of type, we can see that the colours were the ones that were hidden. We can quickly remove the wrong colours and replace them with correct ones by deleting them. Replacing them with the correct colours, of course. This should also work with the spot colours, right? Well, no, they can't be deleted at all. Not for now, at least. The spot colours have been imported from a link graphic, so the graphic will have to be removed or updated first. In this case, I can replace a link used for the graphic that's used in the top left, as I know it's correct. If I try to delete the spot colours now, it works because the spot colours are no longer used in the artwork. So the red and greens are fixed, and everything's great with the world, right? Well, not yet. Notice that to the right of the map there is a black circle that looks quite out of place. If we turn Overprint Preview off and on, we notice that there's white type that disappears and reappears. Why? If we go to the Attributes panel, we can see it has an overprint fill. Overprinting white turns it invisible as there's no ink to overprint, so it becomes transparent. Making white overprint is an old prepress trap that's hard to do in InDesign, but clearly not impossible. If I select other white type, I can't change its overprinting attributes. In this document, the words have been cut and pasted from a graphic in Illustrator that had a white overprint applied to it. To fix it, I can copy the graphic, return to Illustrator, turn the overprint off, return to InDesign, and paste it in, placing it back in the correct position. If I check the separations now, the white text reappears, but if I turn the black separation off, there are still issues. These two elements have colour under the black that will look blurry with ink misregistration on press, so have to be corrected. Once again, the swatches panel shows this line is set as RGB, so I should be able to delete it and replace it with black. The Twitter tag is set in registration, a special colour that appears on any colour separation and is meant for prepress marks only. If I try to delete the colour as I did with the RGB black, I should be able to delete it, right? Well, no. There are several colours in the swatches panel that are in square brackets. That means they're default colors and cannot be deleted. So instead, I have to highlight the type and make it black. There's still an issue with the black circle with the words Superstore. It's possible to see the map under the circle, and that will look bad. Why is that happening? By default, InDesign instructs any type or vector shape that is square brackets black at 100% tint created in InDesign to overprint. This can be changed in the defaults, but in most circumstances it's a good idea, so we'll leave the defaults alone. Overprint black works well for fine type or thin lines over coloured backgrounds to hide on-press misregistration. But in this instance, it's going to look awful. There are one of two fixes. One fix is to make a knockout black by creating a new swatch that is 100% black, but just has a different name. The other is by making a rich black, printer speak for a solid black that contains little but not too much undercolour to boost the blackness within the fill. So this flyer is largely fixed. I could go into more depth about the map, but that'll do for now. Before I go, it's worth pointing out that the separations preview is also present in Adobe Illustrator and Adobe Acrobat. In fact, Adobe Acrobat's panel is much more powerful and can show different color gamuts and how a proof will look based on different color profiles. That's it for another video. If you got something out of this video, show me by hitting the like button and subscribe for more great videos. Check out Colecandoo or InDesign Secrets for the latest articles, or tweet me at Colecandoo. Until next time, I'll see you later.